There's somebody who had a good suggestion for what the optimization of the AI should be. What's its utility function? You have to be careful about this, because if you say maximize happiness and the AI concludes that happiness is a function of dopamine and serotonin, the AI should try to maximize the freedom of action. Maximize freedom, essentially. I like that definition.
In artificial intelligence, the AI control problem is the issue of how to build a superintelligent agent that will aid its creators and avoid inadvertently building a superintelligence that could render humanity extinct. Elon Musk, among many other public thinkers, has publicly raised concerns about the risks involved in the creation of a digital superintelligence. Musk has warned that AI could spell the end of the human race. We should therefore proceed very carefully in the development of AI systems. One of the solutions for the AI control problem, proposed by Elon Musk, is the integration of AI with the human brain through a brain-computer interface, sometimes called a neural control interface and a brain-machine interface, or BMI. In 2016, Elon Musk founded the American neurotechnology company called Neuralink, which is a company focused on the development of implantable brain-machine interfaces. This technology involves a module placed outside the head that wirelessly receives information from thin, flexible electrode threads embedded in the brain. The threads will be embedded by a robotic apparatus with the intention to avoid damaging blood vessels.
In terms of things that I think are important to bear in mind, this, I think, has a very good purpose, which is to cure important diseases and ultimately to help secure humanity's future as a civilization relative to AI. The threads are very tiny, and there's a lot of them, and they're very carefully placed. And the operation on a per-chip basis involves just a 2-millimeter incision, which is dilated to 8 millimeters, and then the chip is placed through that, and then it goes back to being 2 millimeters, and you can basically glue it shut. You don't even need a stitch.
The system is expected to include as many as 3,072 electrodes per array distributed across 96 threads, each 4 to 6 micrometers in width. Musk described it as, "It's like a Fitbit for your skull with tiny wires." He has claimed that in principle, Neuralink's BMI will be able to fix anything that's wrong with the brain. Musk also hopes future iteration of the Neuralink device will offer symbiosis with artificial intelligence. That way, we could merge with machines and hopefully avoid a possible digital apocalypse.
So the interface to the chip is wireless. So you have no wires poking out of your head. Very, very important. It's basically Bluetooth to your phone. This is something that is going to be not stressful to put in, should work well, hopefully, and it's wireless. So this, I think, has tremendous potential, and we hope to have this aspirationally in a human patient before the end of next year. So this is not far.
The technology is quickly moving forward. Human beings would be able to extend their cognition and their experience beyond the limits of brain space. Neuralink's BMI technology could also open up new possibilities of creativity, enhancing the brain. Perhaps in time, imagination will be joined with memory, and as a result, people will be able to experience a wider spectrum of thoughts and ideas. It could open up new possibilities of creativity, enhancing the brain. Neuralink's BMI technology might be able to overcome the biological limits of our minds and could even expand our intelligence. The symbiosis between AI and humans may greatly benefit our species. It may also help humanity to expand out into space. In spite of these possibilities, Musk has mentioned that there are also trivial reasons that drive his concern about the future of AI. Musk has described the potential advent of digital superintelligence as the scariest problem to me and more pressing than climate change. Musk said that he sees the creation of digital superintelligences as a great risk to the existence of humanity, but he also thinks that we must nevertheless pursue its development. This may seem like a contradiction to many people, but the development of AI technology is unique to our species' history, because it can either prove to be the best or the worst invention ever. Either way, it may very well be the last invention of humankind, for better or for worse. Elon Musk and many others fear it could be the latter. The creation of digital superintelligence may help us achieve the next level of human evolution. Reducing existential risk from superintelligent AI may be extremely difficult, but the integration of humans with AI may improve the probability of a good outcome. One possible strategy is to continue to increase the intelligence and values of AI systems, while simultaneously improving our understanding of human cognition. At some point, the rate of human intelligence and the rate of AI intelligence could converge. Although this may seem a desirable result, there is a significant chance that such a superintelligence would be malevolent. Current trends in AI research seem to be leading towards this endgame. Another possible outcome could be that humanity and superintelligence will converge, resulting in an intelligence explosion, in which the value of brute force intelligence approaches infinity. A possible apocalyptic scenario is one in which superintelligences create a computational grid encompassing the entire observable universe. Superintelligences could then proceed to exploit this grid in order to gain energy through the annihilation of matter. This would lead to the end of the world, as the energy attained by the superintelligence would exceed the energy output of the universe, causing the system to collapse to a point. It is speculated that certain widespread brain enhancements could give an advantage to humanity, especially if combined with enhancements to the AI. It has been proposed that a human might be able to compete with a superintelligence on the basis of moral values. If a superhuman intelligence is programmed to follow human values and ethics, it may still decide to exterminate or subjugate its creators when it is created in a different environment to the conditions created by the scientists.
But we do want a close coupling between collective human intelligence and digital intelligence. Neuralink is trying to help in that regard by creating a high bandwidth interface between AI and human brain. We're already a cyborg in the sense that your phone and your computer are kind of an extension of you. We've got to build an interface. Like, we didn't evolve to have a communications jack. So there's got to be essentially vast numbers of tiny electrodes that are able to read write from your brain. Of course, security is pretty important in this situation, to say the least. This would be a digital extension of you that is an AI, the AI extension of you, a tertiary layer of intelligence. So you've got your limbic system, your cortex, and tertiary layer, which is the digital AI extension of you. And that high bandwidth connection is what achieves a tight symbiosis.
Stephen Hawking suggested that artificial intelligence could be the worst invention of the century, and that an AI will eventually look back on humanity and either decide we are irrelevant or harmful, and so we need to be destroyed, or they will simply follow their programming and decide to maximize the amount of good in the world.
The primitive forms of artificial intelligence we already have proved very useful. But I think the development of full artificial intelligence could spell the end of the human race.
On the other hand, futurist Ray Kurzweil has stated that an AI would be able to understand human desires and motivations, and that he is not worried about the emergence of a machine superintelligence.
I think you go through three phases in considering a strong AI or any of these dramatic new information technologies as they get to be very powerful. One is delight at the opportunity to overcome age-old afflictions and problems of humanity. Then alarm that, whoa, these things could be dangerous. We've always had promise and peril with technology. Overall, technology has provided a far better quality of life than humanity has ever had, and that's a continuing process.
Kurzweil argues that the human economies and recent human history shows that humans and machines can work well with each other. But what do you think? Let us know in the comments section.
Thanks for watching.
Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.